Hello friends, welcome back to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And in our previous video we have learned how to create thread by multiple ways, and today we are going to learn the methods, which methods we can use to prevent a thread from execution. We can prevent or stop a thread execution by using the following methods: by using yield method, join method and sleep method. And how we can use yield method? The yield method causes to pause current executing thread for giving the chance of remaining waiting thread of same priority. But if all waiting thread have the low priority, or if there is no waiting thread, then the same thread will be continued as its execution. If several waiting threads with same priority available, then we cannot expect exact which thread will get chance of execution. And the thread which is yielded when it get chance once again for execution is depends on the mercy of the thread scheduler. Everything depends upon thread scheduler. And the signature of the yield method is public, static, native, void yield. Public, static, native, void yield. Let us see in the code how yield method work. Because our thread lifecycle have four states: new state, runnable state, running state and dead state. And once the thread in running state and we have applied yield method, then it will come back into runnable state. Now let us see in the code how yield method will work. Here I have created one class MyThread and extended thread class. We can create thread by extending thread class. And here I have override public void run method, and here I have printed value. For loop will be start from 1 to up to 5. And here I have applied thread dot yield method. But in some operating system yield method not support. Now I will run this application. So first run as Java application. Here we can see the output. First main thread execute, after that child thread, then main thread and again child thread. And what is the join method? When we need to use join method, if a thread want to wait until completing some other thread, then we should go for join method. And the signature of join method is public void join method. We can directly use, or we can use public final void join, and we can pass number in milliseconds, and we can also pass number in milliseconds and nanoseconds, and it will throws interrupted exception. Every join method throws interrupted exception, which is checked exception. Hence compulsory we should handle either by try catch or by using throws keyword. Otherwise we will get compile time error. And this is the example for join method. Man, hey, I will wait for you until you get ready. But after married, hey, get ready in 10 seconds or I am leaving. Now let us see in the code how join method work. Here I have created one class demo thread and extends by thread class. Here I have override run method, and inside for loop I have print value from 1 to 10, and inside this I have printed value child thread. Here I have called thread.sleep for 2 seconds. 2000 millisecond means 2 seconds. Here I have created demo class, and inside this class I have created the object for demo thread that I have created here. When I will call dt.start method, then it automatically call run method and thread will start execute. And inside main thread I have again print for loop that will start from 1 up to 10 and it will print value as main thread. When I will run this application, then we can see the output. Here is main thread. Main thread, after that child thread is printing each and every 2 seconds. Child thread. But if I will use the join method on this thread, then the output will be different. First all child thread will be print. After that main thread will be start because it stopped the execution of another thread. And once the child thread execution will complete, then only main thread will be start execute. Here we can see first the child thread is executing. In previous output our main thread already executed, after that child thread starts. But here the output is different. Now main thread completing. First all child thread, after execution of all child thread, main thread starts and execute. And third one is sleep method. If a thread don't want to perform any operation for a particular amount of time, then we should go for sleep method. And the signature for sleep method is simple: public static native void sleep, and here we can pass times in milliseconds, and it will also throw interrupted exception, and it is a checked exception, so we must need to handle this exception. And another is public static void sleep. Here we can pass time in milliseconds and nanoseconds, and it throws interrupted exception. And sleep method, this means that the thread is out of the queue during this time period and the thread re-enter the runnable state as soon as this time period is elapsed. After completing the time, thread will start execute. Now let us see in the code. Here I have created one class thread sleep demo, and inside this class I have declared main method. Now I will print m, simple value m. After that thread will be stopped for 2 seconds, and after completing these 2 seconds the next line will be print. After that thread will again stop for 2 seconds and then n will be print. So we can say we can use thread.sleep method if we want to perform any operation for a particular amount of time, then we should go for sleep method. Now let us see in the code. Now I will run this application. First m, after 2 seconds a, and after next 2 seconds n will be print. So these are the three methods that we can use to prevent thread execution. And the comparison between yield method, join method and sleep methods are these. First is property purpose. The purpose of yield method to propose current executing thread to give the chance for the remaining thread of same priority and low priority. If a thread want to wait until completing some other thread, then we should go for join. If a thread do not want to perform any operation for a particular amount of time, or if we want to pause, then we should go for sleep. Static yield method is static, but join is not static. And sleep is also static method. It is overloaded. Yield method is not overloaded, only single signature, but join and sleep method are overloaded methods with different signatures. It is final. Yield method is not final, but join method is final, and sleep is also not final. It is throw interrupted exception. Yield method no throws, but join and sleep method throws interrupted exception. These are checked exception, so we must need to handle. It is a native method. Yield method is not native, but join method is native method, and sleep long MS is native, but sleep millisecond nanosecond is non-native. Okay, thanks.